Hello and welcome to the episode 106 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we have two TV appearances, two studio sessions, and two residencies. On the 16th of April 1961, the Beatles performed their usual residency night at a top 10 club with Pete Best on drums. If you want to know more about the band's second residency in Hamburg, West Germany, check out episode 91 of this very podcast. Third German residency 1 year later in 1962, still in Hamburg and still with Pete Best in the lineup. This time, though, the Beatles played the Star Club. Moving on to 1963, we find the Beatles at the Granada TV Centre in Manchester to film a mimed performance of their new single, From Me to You, in front of a live audience for ITV's Scene at 6:30. The whole affair took two rehearsals between 3 and 6 pm, and the actual live broadcast between 6:30 and 7 pm. BBC's The 6:25 show, recorded on the 13th of April, referred to episode 103 of What a Fab Day, was aired today at roughly the same time, 6:25 to 6:50 pm. This meant that in most of the north of England, the Beatles were featured twice at the same time on television. In 1964, the Beatles spent the best part of their day in Notting Hill Gate, filming chase sequences and other exterior scenes for their forthcoming A Hard Day's Night film. Despite the long day, at 7 pm, the band reconvened at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road to record A Hard Day's Night, the song that would serve as the soundtrack for the opening credit of their first feature film, as their next single, and as the title track for their third album. The song was an unusual piece of work for John Lennon and Paul McCartney in being almost a commission. Until then, the two had an idea for a song and let inspiration bring them to destination, but this time at least the title was dictated by the film production. John and Paul had already started writing a bit more on their own, and there was an amicable but fierce competition as to who got the A side of the single. John Lennon came up with the bulk of the song, which was recorded in 9 takes. Two guitars, bass and drums were recorded on the first track of a 4-track recording machine. John's and Paul's vocals were recorded live on track 2, more vocals, percussions, more drums and an acoustic guitar part on track 3, a piano part performed by George Martin plus the guitar solo and the outro on track 4. The session was wrapped up at 10 pm. On the 16th of April 1965, George Harrison and John Lennon were at the Wembley Studios in London to appear on ITV's Ready Steady Go to promote the Beatles' Ticket to Ride single through an interview with host Cathy McGowan. This was the only remaining option offered to them after a live performance had been ruled out. The show, broadcast live between 6:08 and 7 pm, had actually acquired a new name from the 2nd of April. Ready Steady Goes Live. The temporary name change signaled a shift to a live-only music policy to try and bring new life to the 18-month-old program. The original name would return in June 1965. Despite the constant rumors of its cancellation, the program would continue until December 1966. Talking about 1966, it was then, on this date, between 2:30 pm and 1:30 am, that the Beatles completed Rain at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. Today, the song acquired a new bass part, more vocals, including the final backwards part in the coda, and a tambourine. At the end of the long session, 4 mono mixes of the song were produced. And before the final story of the day, let me remind you to please visit www.simonmas.com/support if you want to lend me a hand to produce more music-related content for you to enjoy, with an eye on increasing the production values. Any donation or help is warmly welcomed, as any comment or message about your views on this podcast, things you like or that you would do differently. Thank you for making the difference. On the 16th of April 1969, after recording a second demo of Old Brown Shoe between 2:30 and 5 p.m. at the EMI studios, George Harrison was joined by John Lennon and Paul McCartney to have a group recording of two of his songs, the aforementioned Old Brown Shoe and Something. With Ringo Starr away for the filming of The Magic Christian, the session, stretching from 7 p.m. to 2:45 a.m., so the band recording four takes of the rhythm track of the first song, with drums played by Paul, lead guitar, piano and rhythm guitar with a guide vocal, followed by overdubs, bass, more lead guitars, lead vocals and backing vocals. Once the work on Old Brown Shoe had been completed, the three Beatles recorded 13 takes of the Something rhythm track with Paul on drums, George on rhythm guitar, John on bass and George Martin on piano. The session ended with three tentative stereo mixes of Old Brown Shoes. This concludes today's episode of What a Fab Day. Tune in tomorrow for more juicy stories about the life of the four you love. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.